System 32, one of the many folders in the Windows installation directory. You've probably seen it, or maybe the meme about deleting it, which you should not do. Obviously, it's an important folder, but certainly not the only one. So what exactly is its purpose, and why isn't there a System 64 folder? That's what we're going to go over and more. Oh, and if you're curious what does happen if you do delete System 32, I made a video testing that out years ago. I'll put the link to that at the end if you want to check it out afterwards. So to understand things, first we can go over where did System 32 come from. In the very early first versions of Windows, way back when it was only 16-bit, there was actually a system folder. And it had only a handful of truly core parts of the Windows installation, like the kernel itself, some important drivers, and a couple system utilities. But the rest of it, and any other system apps, were just right in the Windows installation directory at the top level. It was a pretty flat folder structure. When Windows 32-bit came around, though, aka Windows NT, which technically even modern versions of Windows are based on the same overall architecture, they created System 32, and they started to organize things a little bit differently. Compared to the purpose of the old system directory, System 32 would still have the very core stuff like the kernel, but it would have a bit broader of a scope. I'm gonna go over more exact details about what it contains later, but for some examples, they moved the 32-bit versions of system utilities into System 32, not just the Windows directory. It also contains DLLs, shared libraries used by other programs, as well as drivers for hardware and system configurations. I will point out that there is still a system folder in the Windows directory to this day, but it's empty, except for some reason, for me at least, it has the speech folder in there. I don't know why that is, but fun fact. And after a while, when Windows 64-bit came around, wait a minute, why isn't there a System 64 folder? Where did the 64-bit versions of the programs go? Well, you'll notice there is another folder called SysWOW64, which basically has all the same apps, so that must be it, right? But no, in Windows 64-bit, which you're probably using right now, the 64-bit apps are in System 32. And the 32-bit programs of the system apps went into the SysWOW64 folder. So yes, the names are completely backwards, but there is a reason for that. You see, when Microsoft created 64-bit Windows, they didn't want anything to break. They wanted everything to work seamlessly, even if it was a 32-bit program running on 64-bit version of Windows. But they obviously still needed 64-bit to be the main backend for everything in Windows itself, obviously. So they just kept System 32 as the directory with all the main system components in it, now 64-bit, even if the 32 part doesn't make sense anymore. But to still be able to run 32-bit programs on the 64-bit system, they created a new subsystem, it's called, and this had the name Windows 32-bit on Windows 64-bit, which is what that WOW64 part of that folder name stands for. It pretty much stores an entire second version of all the Windows components, except the 32-bit versions of them. And then if any of those components are needed by some app, Windows automatically will use whichever version is necessary for the compatibility automatically and seamlessly in the background. So let's take a closer look at what is inside System 32. I mentioned some of these before, but we can look at it in more detail. First, of course, is the kernel of the operating system. This is the true absolute core of the operating system. This is going to handle all the really, really low level stuff. But as you'll notice, it's basically only one thing. But also in here are a whole bunch of DLL files, or shared libraries, dynamic link libraries. And these all have different functionalities that programs can use. And these also make up the Windows API. The Windows API is literally the DLL files themselves. For example, if you wanted to show a Windows error message box, you could directly call the message box function, which is in user32.dll, which you guessed it, is in System 32. Now, most application frameworks abstract this away so you don't have to use the exact struct and everything when you go to call the DLL, but still. There's also driver-related folders, like literally the drivers folder, as well as driver store, and these contain sys files, which are binaries, but they're for drivers. For configurations of the system, including the Windows registry itself, that's gonna be in the config folder. There's also security catalogs in the cat root folder that contains signatures of trusted files and stuff to make sure that a file is legitimate and it can be stored all in one place. And that would potentially be in addition to the signature on the file itself. And then it also will contain other subsystems for stuff like application control for businesses to control what apps can run on the system, or even the printer spooler service and event logging. Now, if you look further through the System32 folder, you'll notice that there's some EXEs in here and they might seem kind of familiar. For example, ping.exe, checkdisk.exe, sfc.exe, and if you haven't realized already, that's right. A lot of what you think of as commands in the command prompt are actually just independent exe applications in the System32 folder that you're running. That's because System32 is included in the so-called path environment variable in Windows, which basically tells the operating system which folder directories to look into. If you run a command without specifying an absolute path, it will then look in one of those folders to see if that file is in there, and System32 is one of them. So that's why you can run those EXEs from anywhere in the system. And there are a few other paths that are in this path environment variable, and you can actually add some yourself, either for the whole system or just your own user profile. Now let's take a step back though, because okay, we know what's in System32, but how does that compare to what's a level up in the general Windows installation directory? Now, most things in the C Windows directory are going to be important, obviously, so I can't look at every single thing in there, but we can take a closer look at some of the more core folders. For example, there's the boot directory, which contains the stuff necessary to actually start up Windows. I already mentioned the SysWow64 folder. It's pretty similar to System32, except obviously not quite as critical as System32 because it's only the 32-bit stuff, which is not as central. The WinSXS folder is an interesting one. That stands for Windows Side-by-Side, aka the Windows Component Store. This actually stores multiple different versions and copies of different components of Windows. For example, if we search regedit in here, we'll find several different copies of it. And the reason for each one being in there might be that it's from a previous build after a Windows update, like in case you need to roll back the feature, it might still have it in there as a backup. Or if you enable and disable features in Windows, it might use different versions of a certain component and it would just pull from the proper one. And it could be used if a certain component gets corrupted, it could check if the one in the component store is correct and then use that. There's plenty of other important folders. One example is software distribution. This is going to contain stuff and is used by Windows Update. And there's also the INF folder, which has to do with drivers, contains .inf files, which stores metadata and stuff about the drivers and devices they support, stuff like that. In addition to the really important folders, you also have auxiliary resources, you might call them. For example, there's the media folder, which contains all the different Windows system sounds, as well as the cursor folder, which contains images of the actual cursors, as well as the fonts folder, stuff like that. So at the end of the day, what is System32? Well, it houses the core parts and components of Windows, as well as different system utilities. And why isn't there a System64 folder? Well, that's because System32 is what System64 would have been. They just kept the name the same for compatibility. Now, if you think I missed something important, let me know down in the comments. Maybe it warrants another video about that topic. And if you enjoyed the video, of course, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up, smash the like button. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. I'll put a link to that video I mentioned before where I deleted System32 while Windows was running. It was a few years ago, but it still applies. I'll put that link right there. And I also made another video about what if you delete the Windows folder entirely. Both of those will just be on the side here. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.